Why is it so important to know how to write bug reports? Well, professional written bug reports bring order and efficiency into software development and testing process. In a sense, bug reports establish a communication protocol between all teammates and stakeholders that keeps all the team on the same page. If you are a QA engineer, a product owner, or a non-techie wearing multiple hats on your head, this video is for you. Hi, I am Katya, a senior QA engineer at QAwerk, a software testing agency based in Ukraine. Today, I'll share with you tips for writing professional bug reports. I'll walk you through bug report objectives, attributes, and structure in detail. Later, I'll also share a link explaining how to distinguish professional written bug reports from amateur ones. So please watch until the end to understand the tips and see hands-on examples. First, let's talk about bug report objectives. A bug report is a technical document that serves as a means of communication between testers, developers, and other project stakeholders. It helps standardize the way bugs are identified and reported. When everyone is following a standard, less time is spent on back and forth communication, and everyone understands what needs to be fixed and how urgent the issue is. So, what should a bug report look like to meet those objectives? Let's go over each element of the bug report structure step by step. The first thing you will see in a bug tracking system is a summary, also called a title. In simple terms, a summary is a short overview of the bug. It should be concise, but descriptive enough for developers to understand the problem at a glance. Following the what, where, and when rule is the best way to do that. Basically, you say what doesn't work, in which area of the app, and when this happens, like what conditions lead up to the bug. If you are using Jira, the next very important element you'll see is the description field. Here you mention preconditions, steps to reproduce, actual and expected results. Preconditions are actions you take before the steps to reproduce a bug. They are important because they help isolate the issue and identify its triggers. Login as a particular user, changing theme, language on your phone, and so on. Next are steps to reproduce a bug. This part is quite self-explanatory. These are a set of detailed instructions that guide developers on how to reproduce a bug. Steps to reproduce should be numbered, given in sequential order and imperative mode. The next bug report section is the actual result. The observed behavior of the software under the test. It shows what actually happens when a particular set of actions are performed. Expected result. Expected result is the behavior documented in the app's requirement specifications. It actually shows how the app should function if everything is in order. Suppose you are testing a sign-up form. You fill out all the fields correctly, but for name field you enter only spaces. In this case, the expected result will be a red notification message explaining what is wrong, highlighting of the name field in red, and displaying of the validation text. The last block of the description field is additional information. It is optional, but sometimes it is really needed. Any supplementary details, remarks, and observations go here. For example, if the bug is also reproduced on other pages, you need to mention that, and this information that the bug is not local but system will be very important for the developer. Or another example, if the bug is not triggered when you just slightly change the input, it also worth mentioning. All these details help developers isolate the bug and get the root cause of the issue quicker. Alright, let's continue. The next fields in a bug report are priority and severity. They are not interchangeable, so please don't confuse them. Priority refers to the level of urgency. It means how fast a bug should be fixed. It denotes a bug's impact on a client's business. Priority can also change depending on other factors. For example, when a minor bug blocks more important functionality, and so on. Priority can be low, medium, and high. Severity, on the other hand, refers to the extent a bug impacts the app's functionality. Severity types are categorized as a block, critical, major, minor, and trivial. A bug with a block of severity makes further use of the app impossible. The next field is environment. It describes the environment of hardware, software, and network in which the bug occurred. Examples of the environment details are name and version of the operating system, browser, internet connection, a specific number of the build, etc. Next on our list are attachments. Here we add the visual proof of the bug. It can be a simple screenshot with red arrows highlighting the issue, log or configuration files, or a video. Any other artifacts are also possible if they help to understand the bug better. Finally, there is a field for linked issues. Here, testers add other tickets that in one way or another are related to the reported bug. Linked issues show interdependencies between tickets and help improve bug report management. These are core blocks that you will find in any bug reporting system. Depending on your project workflow, you may also need to add due dates, print, or select a relevant epoch. Now let's talk about the characteristics of a well-written bug report. First of all, a bug report should be clear. In other words, all teammates who read it should understand what is wrong at the first glance. Secondly, a good bug report should be concise. It is not an essay. Its goal is to describe the issue in a few words, to keep it neat and easy to comprehend. The third important characteristic of a bug report is preciseness. The bug should be isolated as much as possible. That's why it's so important to write exact preconditions, steps to reproduce actual and expected outcomes. Also, a professionally written bug report is always comprehensive. It should be written in a way no one asks any additional questions. If you would like to know more about do's and don'ts creating a bug report, make sure to check this video. I will also share a link in the description. Well, that's it for today. I do hope that the information in the video was useful to you. I would be really happy to see your like or comment under the video. Before you leave, I would also like to mention that QAwerk company can help you establish effective QA process from the ground up. We have over 8 years of commercial experience and have already worked with such big names as Squarespace. So, if you feel that your product needs better testing, please reach out. My teammates and I would be really glad to share our experience. That's it for today. See you soon.